forgot all about the library like she told her old man now. And with the radio blasting goes cruising just as fast as she can now. And she'll have fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes a T-bird away.
Fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes a T-bird
well,
away.
Well, the girls can't stand her cause she walks from surprise like a big
fan.
He
walks like a big fan. He walks
like
a big fan.
She makes a giddy vibe. Put her lip by her lip.
Of a girl named Victoria Millán.
Who?
Oh, it's a story.
I want to hear it.
Really?
No, we are here to look the church, not to hear stories.
Why? Are you scared, honey?
No, it's just that I don't want to waste the time.
But we have all the day. We have time for a short story.
Please, Patrick.
Look, your girlfriend and her sister are begging you to hear the story.
Okay, gosh.
Well, come.
There was a beautiful woman. Her name was Victoria Millán. She was a very jealous girl, and her boyfriend, Acelo, was a womanizer. He always was with another woman. Victoria knew that, but she never talked about it with him. Victoria was enchanted because she thought that after the wedding, he was going to be a wonderful husband and he was going to stop deceiving, but it wasn't
right. Oh my god. It's horrible.
Yes, but let me keep with the story, okay?
Okay.
Okay, where was? Oh, yes. The day of the wedding, Victoria was completely beautiful with her wedding dress, but her mother and her fiancé wasn't there.
She stood there, waiting and waiting, but any of both didn't come. The people started to leave, and she didn't know what happened.
So, when Victoria saw that all the people were talking about how terrible was her wedding, she began to leave the church. But Victoria didn't care what they said. She was so angry with her mom and her fiancé because she thought that they were together. So, she started to get crazy. she began to dream about her mom and her boyfriend together, and one day, she woke up with the idea that she had to kill her mom, and actually...
OMG, it isn't okay to get crazy, because you start to have crinkles. You know what removes crinkles? Nothing removes crinkles.
Isabella,
what?
Shut up!
Okay, well, Victoria actually died in this church.
Really? But Patron and I are going to get married to the discharge.
Well, if you are a good fiancé, you don't have anything to get worried, right? But if you are with some other girl, maybe La Sayana come to see you, honey.
What are you trying to say, huh?
Nothing. I didn't say anything.
Yo creo que se está ocultando algo.
Well, let's continue with the story. Victoria wasn't good. She think that her mother was trying to restore her life, but it wasn't real. Because her mother didn't come to the wedding, because Victoria locked her in her house the day before. But she forget it because she was crazy, very, very crazy.
Yes, so she think that she need to kill her mom, for she supposed that a voice in her head said,
yeah, but the worst part was when she went to her mother's home to kill her.
When she get into her mother's home and she came into the house, she start to talk with her mom and make her some tea. But instead of sugar, she put some poison.
So, mother, why you didn't came to my wedding?
Well, honey, I don't know why, but my door was locked and the windows too.
Oh, really? And you know what? My fiance never came to the wedding.
What a horrible story! It's not a lie that she was crazy!
Yes, but if you let us keep with the story...
Okay.
Did you know what she did when she got to her mother's home?
No.
She went to his fiance's house and did you know what she found?
She found him with another girl. The girl ran away, but he didn't have so luck.
I'm going to kill you.
Victoria killed him.
She was so distraught and repentant for killing her own mother, so she went to the church to confession. That actually was the same church that she chose to get married, for God to forgive her and she could live in peace.
But
the plans did not get as she wanted, because the price caught her.
Saying that she was an evil being who was going to be eternally roaming, she would have to pay for being a sinner. That a mother was sacred, and finally the price back.
And please, get out of the church. You are not welcome in God's house.
Really? Well, I don't believe in these kinds of stories, but...
I do believe it too! Do you see, we have so many things in common. Then Victoria went out of the church and she started to feel hot and feel sick, and she began to have convulsions and died.
From that day, everyone in the city began to feel his presence, and then myths were invented when several local people said that they saw her, but some people say that it was just for attention.
Then this story was created to scare the tourists.
Did you see Nicole? It's a lie.
Honey, you can say anything you want, but it's not gonna make it a lie.
Well, that's the entire story?
Yes, actually the other part is a little bored, because some people said that they saw a beautiful woman with a wedding dress, but they can't see her face, because her long and blonde hair covers everything except the mouth. She does a beautiful smile, then they follow her. She gets into the woods, but they can't stop because she enchanted her.
So, well, when they get into the woods, she stopped walking. She starts to sing a sad song about the wedding that she never had. They try to kiss her, but she moves her blonde hair and they saw the devil of the woman in white.
No! I don't want to keep hearing this stupid story! Let's go to the beach!
Are you?
No! I'm not afraid! I just wanna go to the beach, okay?
Okay, well, let's go to the beach. Fine. There is a beach here in Guacuco, which is beautiful.
Well, which isn't you, right, Patrick?
Yes, and after this story is best.
Fidelity has a price, a very expensive price. Maybe I will come to see you in your wedding, Patrick.
What? Because you are so special for me.
Come on, I know that.
You know what?
That...
This wall is so beautiful.
Yes, yes. Don't you think that, Nicole?
Yeah, sure. Well, I'm going to sleep.
Bye.
Bye.
Here in the house of God to join this beautiful couple in holy matrimony. Nicole Thompson, do you accept this man to be your husband for the entire life till death does you part?
Yes, I do.
Patrick Adams, do you accept this woman to be your wife for the rest of your life